It's a great honor to be here on the 50th anniversary of Dr. King's March on Washington. It's very humbling to be allowed to connect with you in this way. Each of you came here with individual goals and intentions, which at first glance may seem separate and exclusive. But we all share a common bond. Your presence here today says you care and want to bring more peace, love, and harmony into the world. Together, we must embrace this moment. In my travels as a Goodwill Ambassador for Peace, both here and abroad, I have observed revolutions and social change firsthand. I've seen youth senselessly killed, people struggling for food, for a decent home, education, and justice. And I am often reminded of the marches and the sit-ins we experienced here during the 60s. And I remember the words of Dr. Martin Luther King, which were, "I have decided to stick with love. Hate is too great a burden to bear." We've all seen images from those days of the civil rights movement. Pictures of segregated water fountains, public waiting rooms, movie theaters. And in those amazing photos, I've always been drawn to the men, women, and children who were the silent heroes. Many remain nameless, but their heroic faces captured the portraits of the past to remind us of their sacrifice. They risked their lives working tirelessly to bring about change. Today, I want to celebrate those nameless individuals as we reflect on the last 50 years. And in doing so, I want you to recognize the hero that exists inside yourselves. To understand that every step you take around an unknown corner marks your bravery. When we overcome life's hurdles, when we face and conquer our fears, when we help others become their better selves, we are committing small acts of heroism. And if I were to take a picture of this crowd right now, people would see some of your faces in the movements that are starting today. This is your moment to join those silent heroes of the past. Individuals who stood in the very spot where you stand today. You now have the responsibility to carry the torch. As we gather here at the foot of the Lincoln Memorial, as hundreds of thousands did on this day 50 years ago, I remain encouraged and inspired. Let's be the generation to make a true difference in the world. Let's create meaningful change, change that we can all believe in and share in. My mother always told me, "You don't have to believe in the things that I believe, but you have to believe in something. Search. Search to find the thing that you believe in, the thing that you believe will help mankind, and then act upon it, like so many of the silent heroes and heroines of the movement. Each of us can spark change by working to strengthen our communities and to shape our common destiny. So as the bell rings today, my dream is that something will resonate inside you and me that will remind us each of our common bond." I'd like to leave you with these words by Dr. King. "Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. I can never be what I ought to be until you are what you ought to be." May God bless you. May we remain connected in love. We are one. Thank you.